And we are back with the last series of the night. We got Dusa Gaming, who's going to be facing up against Power Rangers in PR's doubleheader for the night, this last two-game series. So, guys, let's just get into it right away, because I just got to cool out a little bit. Just got to cool out. Baking under these studio lights and coughing all over the place. So that's why I'm going to welcome in my co-caster. I'm going to welcome in my co-caster. Pimp Muckle's going to be joining me for the last series of the night. Pimp, what's going on, man?
Yeah, I just had to make a promise to some people to make a stupid accent. I just did that. So I can actually just go and talk usual. Once again, I get, you know, some people like my Schwarzenegger voice. So I was like, huh? Why not do something in the introduction? It's going to be one heck of a draft anyway, so you might as well have some fun here. I mean, you know what? I want to cast for fun. I'm not sure about you, but I assume you're going to do the same. So,
it's the business. I get paid
a business,
professional at all times. let's have some fun with this one, because it's sure to be a fun affair. We got the Russians and the Ukrainians facing up against the Belarusians. So it's going to be a good fair. So we got Lycan as well as the Batrider being banned away. Centaur and Ember Spirit taken out by Power Rangers. Invoker going to pick up as well as the Ancient Apparitions for PR. Nyx Assassin as well as the Visage going the way of Dusa. And I mean, maybe it's just because we were casting Fnatic, but this time around, a lot less definitive drafting in the first 1-2.
Yeah. That's like so crazy, because if you draft as a team like Fnatic, you always are looking for this Wisp, for these Fnatic heroes. And I don't know, like, Fnatic is just such a super versatile team. I feel like they can play every hero there is. So you never know what to expect if it's not a Tiny Wisp. If they can get their hand on the Tiny Wisp, screw everything. Let's go Tiny Wisp, go balls to the walls, aggression, and let's just do it. But so far, well, Dusa, it's always with one of those not exactly like tier one teams that Dusa can pull up something very crazy. And so far, a Visage pick very early on is something rather unusual.
Yeah, Visage, Nyx Assassin, leaving their lineup really, really open, that's for sure. Power Rangers, a little bit more locked down with the Invoker pickup, but he's still an extremely versatile core hero. Can run with many, many different strategies. Lifestealer, as well as the Naga Siren, banned out by Dusa. Meanwhile, we have the Templar Assassin and the Bane being banned out by Power Rangers. So, taking away one of the mids they don't want to deal with up against the Invoker. A Templar Assassin, one of the few heroes who can actually win the lane up against an Invoker. And then as well, taking away the Bane, apparently feeling that was going to be the support of choice, but it's actually going to be a Rubick in the hands of Dusa. And in my mind, Mirana is a very, very high-tier pickup right now. That's a kill lane. Rubick, Mirana, Visage. It doesn't have to be a Mirana. It could be pretty much any carry that has some sort of nuke, but that is going to be a potential kill lane if Dusa want to run it aggressive.
Yeah, actually, I have to agree. Like, I usually cast CA Dota, and Mirana was and still is the very, very, very high valued pick. Usually see her picking up face boost Midas and played as a split push one position, and less active around the map as opposed to some teams like, Fnatic picking up the Era or Trixie Mirana. But well, still, like, she's so high up there. And I was surprised when I tried to commentate, what the freaking hell's going, some CIS Dota, that there was like no Mirana being picked up at all. And now look at this. What the freaking hell are we watching? We see a Wisp and a block pick from the Tiny.
Seriously? Well, all right. Okay. So block picking, not really going to work out, because there's still something that Power Rangers can have, and they almost immediately grab it. They lose very, very little sleep over the Tiny being grabbed by Dusa. They're just like, well, whatever, we'll grab it with CK. That's an old-school combo that is still decently strong. Now, it's not as strong as it once was. It used to pretty much wreck everything that got that ran into, but it's still going to be a good combo, and I'm excited, man. I'm excited to see Wiz CK back into the game. That was one of the more obnoxious Wiz combos that you could think about.
Yeah. Also, one thing to note about the Tiny, I don't think he's bad, because Chaos Knight relies so much on his illusions to actually deal a crap ton of damage, and those things take a bit more than the usual hero, obviously. So a Tiny who's reasonably farmed with some AC and an Aghanim Scepter, he's going to cleave through them all, and I think this is actually a good call here. The problem is, Dusa don't have anything apart from the Tiny Cleave and the Nyx Assassin stun to be actually AoE damage. And that's a bit of a problem. Maybe they can pick up something like a Queen of Pain now just to get rid of those freaking illusions. But the CK will obviously go Armlet because it's just the best item on the CK, period. And I feel like if you just pop your Armlet, get your illusions up, it's like those things, man. They are tanky.
Chat is confused. Apparently I didn't make this obvious enough. But when I was talking about the Russians and the Ukrainians, they are together. That is Dusa. Dusa is half Ukrainian, half Russian.
That's like Navi.
So yeah, it's Power Rangers. Power Rangers is Belarus. So yep. they are nowhere in that. They are not in that category. So guys, calm down. I'm not promoting war between Ukraine and Russia. I'm promoting peace here. I'm promoting cooperation, and that is in a shining example, which is Dusa Gaming.
Yeah,
connecting Ukrainian players and Russian players together in the beauty of esports.
It actually is. Like, that's a big deal, I feel like. In esports, everyone is not only equal, but every like country is also some sort of equal. You're going to have some Russian players, you're going to have some Belarusians, some, I don't know, whoever's going to be coming up from CIS, and they're all obviously communicating in Russian because it's just the general language, which is English in the EU West region, it's Russian in the East region. So it's completely fine, and everyone doesn't hate each other at all because it's just freaking esports. Everyone is equal, and that's a very good, I would say, state of mind. Like, seriously, this is a big deal, and this is why esports is seriously pretty damn cool. I mean, look at those teams like Na'Vi. They're Russians, they're Ukrainians, they've got a German in there. He's half Iranian. Like, Kuro saw everything there is, pretty much, and that's just ridiculously cool. And actually, back to the draft, Magnus, that's a good counter here to the Chaos Knight illusions, I feel like.
Yep, we're going to have a big ol' RP on top of that. You wanted to see some cleave in action from the Tiny. Well, man, you are going to get cleaves out of your mind between the Aghanims as well as the Empower. This Tiny is going to be hitting like a truck and creaming through everything that he gets his hands on. Cheshire Cat, though, he's going to be picking up a timber saw. We'll see if he opts to go for Hani's race car build that we saw earlier with the Phase Drums Yule Scepter build for timber saw. Kind of doubt it, but still, no matter what, timber saw, strong pickup since we've got two different strength heroes on the board.
Yeah, I actually like it. Like, seriously, Timbersaw is just so nice against all these strength-based heroes. Not only do you get less damage from them, you're also just going to be taking away so much HP. And this CK, if he crits from time to time, I mean, this is just the mother of randomness, pretty much, the CK. He's got a, like, 30 damage spread on level 1. It's ridiculous to last it with him. It's really annoying, actually. But you're going to have a crit who deals a crap ton of damage at a very low crit chance of 10%. And then you've got your illusions, and you've got your Reality Rift. Everything is freaking random. Wherever you are actually ending up on a Reality Rift is random. The stun is random. Everything is random. But you know what? That's completely fine, because if you actually get the deeps there, like, if you've got the items to boot, you don't care about the random rolls. You just kill everyone regardless.
Yeah, I'm interested to see how effective Chaos Knight Wisp is going to be in this game, because we actually have a pretty decent... So this isn't like Chaos Knight just being forced to pick up and going, ah, this sucks, he doesn't really fit into our lineup, but he's a Wisp hero, right? Like, they've actually got a really good lineup behind him. First of all, Chaos Knight, going all the way back to when Chaos Knight Wisp was really popular, he's somewhat situational as a hard carry. I personally don't often. I want to be able to see some sort of soft semi-carry behind him. And Invoker will fill that role. He will fill that role just because Invoker is always strong going into late game. So if this goes late enough, still going to have some sort of presence. We also have the Timbersaw, who will fall off in the late game, but gives a lot of good mid-game presence, and that will combo off of the aggression that the Chaos Knight Wisp has. And then on top of that, you've got the Ancient Apparition, not only for the global capacity with Ice Blast, that's going to be a powerful combo with Relocate, but also the fact that Cold Feet works really well with the Chaos Knight. So they've got everything set up to go with the Chaos Knight. The question is, how well will he really perform in this meta and up against Deuce's team, who right now, we're going to be seeing a tri-lane versus a tri-lane scenario. They've got the defensive tri-lane for Tiny. They're going to try and protect him up against the aggression of the Chaos Knight early on. I kind of favor Dusa in this tri-lane scenario. I feel that, like, as strong as Chilling Touch is, as strong as Spirit, as much damage as there is coming out from the Wisp Balls, I feel like the direct bursting power is to the favor of Dusa. As soon as you get to level 2, they have much better burst potential just between the Visage-Tiny combo.
Yeah, the problem is, I'm not sure. Actually, just let me do the math real quick. Okay, so he is going to not have a full combination up on level 2. the tiny that is. So they can't burst someone down level 2. And these, wow, they're actually going to be going once again. Wow, look at this damage already. They're going to have a very quick tether forward, and that just happened.
All right, well, don't go forward against that combo at level 1. Like, Chilling Touch, really strong level 1. Maybe play a little bit more passively. I don't know, man. But they just, like, Tiny just, like, head-butted into that full tri-lane. And no surprise, he gets bursted down real quickly. So Power Rangers pick up the first blood real quickly. And from there, they just gives them such an advantage. Because now Dusa has to play so passive. They have to get pulls off. Like, I was thinking pull, play passive, get level 2, maybe level 3. Then you've got the Tiny combo, the Visage. You burst one hero, and then maybe you trade after that. But you're still making a one-for-one trade against an aggressive tri-lane. Good to go. But they just, I don't know, didn't really respect the damage from Power Rangers at level 1.
Yeah, it's a bit unfortunate, I have to say. Because every other lane should be going rather okay-ish. Iceberg can just, you know, have his go in the mid lane. Bottom lane could be... Obviously, it's favored for Cheshire Cat. He's a freaking Timbersaw, so that's... It's going to be a lane where he's going to get so much farm, but still, the Nyx Assassin can still farm a bit. So he's going to be finding a bit of CS here and there. It's going to be completely fine. And as soon as he's 6, well, he can just rotate. But top lane, oh man, that's really unfortunate.
Yep, they're cleaning up the stack. They just took control of it, and there was nothing... nothing Dusa could really do at that point in time. And now they're just waiting to get level 3, and maybe they can make some sort of turnaround. But in the meantime, take a look at some of the CS. We've got 10 and 2 right now for the Timbersaw in this bottom lane. And Cheshire Cat is going for what Hani did early on with his Timbersaw. He picked up an Orb of Venom. At top, though, Tiny's going to fall. Once again, getting picked up by the combo.
It's just ridiculous. It just really is. I don't even know. Like, they didn't even need the stun.
They're losing heroes left and right. Iceberg barely got his bottle in time, or else he would have fallen as well. He barely got the bottle to him and started charging up, but Scandal, he almost made that dive into a kill. Turnaround, though, at top. Moon will fall. And finally, Dusa get themselves on the board. After a bunch of back-and-forth action, they get their full combo off and are able to kill the tanky-ass Chaos Knight.
Yeah, and also there's going to be Haste Rune picked up by the Magnus, who's just... running himself back to the mid lane, so he's going to be finding a bit more, and he's not going to be too... Well, he's going to be rather happy about this one. Obviously, still going to be going for some harassment, as well as, of course, the, well, CSing with his Shockwave. But apart from this, not too much happening. Apart from, of course, the kills in 3 minutes, don't get me wrong. But bottom lane is where it's at, actually, in my opinion. Because the Nyx is going to have some Arcane Boots up at still a good-ish time, and then it all comes down to this guy now turning around Cheshire Cat. But he doesn't have too much mana. Now he's got one Whirling Death. Well, that's a die from Cheshire Cat, but no TP reactions coming in at all. Because everyone's just way too stuffed.
Yeah, there's no way, but he's gonna... Cheshire Cat was looking like he almost wants to go for the kill here. He's still gonna try and go for the dive. He has that high-level reactive armor, and the creeps are actually tanking up the tower, and Cheshire Cat, free to just beat on this Nyx Assassin, will be able to get out by trading the aggro onto the creep. So well done by him. He just won his lane, shut down the Arcane Boots that you were talking about, and gonna be able to get himself some Arcane Boots if he wants to, but... We'll see if that actually happens.
Yeah, maybe Pulsahani can just pick up his face boots right now, but I think the face boots really is only a counter to the summon strat. Like, seriously, it doesn't make sense for me. Yeah, there you go. It's gonna be a cane boots. Top lane, though. Top rune. Oh, bit of a skirmish. Magnus wanted to go for the illusion rune, has forced a bottle crawl. Oh, that's a small win.
Yeah, and on top of that, a full bottle will really help out Moon. They're gonna be able to just go on somebody here. Possibly the Tiny. Like, the lack of armor for this Tiny is really the biggest issue early on in this laning phase. I almost feel like he needed a Ring of Protection to bring himself into this lane, because you talked about the Chaos Knight's auto attacks. It's just kind of insane. He could be hitting for 94 damage. When he hits you, he could right now, level 4, hit you for 94 damage. That's like a Treant Protector smashing you in the face, man. That's just, like, so unfair. So when you have zero armor and you're taking that full amount of damage, it's like a small nuke that's hitting you.
Yeah. I mean, he's getting this slowly, but he's got a 0.9 agility gain. That's nothing. So he's not going to be seeing any sort of armor. This is why you pick up an AC, obviously, on the hero, so that's a big deal. Also bottom lane, Legion, once again, has to be a bit careful, but he's got a mana burn, so Cheshire Cat doesn't have any sort of spells to his arsenal. But yeah, in the end, still, he's doing mad work. 29 for 3 against the Nyx Assassins, 15-1.
They're ping out, they're going to go on Limbo and get the 3-second stun on top of that, meaning Cold Feet will land, and there's nothing to be able to save Limbo, they'll just simply right-click him down. The supports need to be able to get out here. Courier is going to be able to bring the boots in, but not in time as Captain Love. That's that full bottle coming into play, and they're going to go for a full-on wipe here as Moon continues to dive in, but does not actually try and finish off Capron. He had the full amount of mana if he wanted to go for that dive. He had Chaos Bolt, he had Reality Rift, but he probably knew it's early enough in the game that these low death timers mean that this Tiny was going to be coming back in right behind him with the teleport, and it's not worth feeding away a Chaos Knight kill at that point.
Yeah. Also, 6-minute rune. Everyone was going for it. No one's got it. Now it's bottom lane sitting there. Looking pretty. And now top lane. They want to go into Moon. They're going to be slowing him up. And it's a full avalanche combination. No, actually not. They're waiting so long. In the end, doesn't matter. And that's a big kill. So 5-2 on the board. Doozer can still come back. The Tiny is going to be a force to be reckoned with if he gets some farm up. And so far, it's looking not that great, but obviously, like, they can still come back if they find a bit more pickoffs. And supports rotating to the mid lane is always an issue, because this killing lane on the top from Doozer can still just wreck the Chaos Knight.
Yeah, not only are Power Rangers right now winning in kills, but they're also winning in CS really, really hard. 35-6 on the Timbersaw, 26-11 on our Invoker, and that leaves 26-3 on Moon. Like, he's still farming, free farming, in aggressive tri-lane. You know, that's just bad, bad sign. And we do have Wiz coming back to the top lane, but you need the full-on support just because this burst potential of the Tiny Visage is a little too scary. But Limbo needs mana right now, and he's got nothing. He doesn't even have enough to throw down a stun. Nyx Assassin will come in, though, with his Vendetta. But look at that. Counter ward already in place. They see the rotation in and are going to be able to back out. And just like that, Legion has wasted not only a teleport, but a lot of time and his Vendetta in trying to gank this top lane. All the meanwhile, Cheshire Cat completely free farming bottom.
Oh, look at this super smart play. They've got counter wards in every freaking lane. Scandal can't get ganked. Top can't get ganked. What is the Nyx Assassin going to be doing? And now Limbo once again getting initiated. 3 seconds done, and he's just getting blown up like this. Yeah, and once again, like, this power of the CK Wisp, as well as the Chilling Touch, this Chilling Touch is just paying so much. Like, they just get the kills because of it, and it's ridiculous damage.
Yep, it's crazy, especially with the added damage of Reality Rift. You're hitting for extra 75 damage from Reality Rift. You give in, right now, an extra 70 damage. It's just insanity. It's absolutely insanity. You're hitting for like 200 damage with that one Reality Rift hit. It's insane. Haste Rune is going to be picked up by FNG. Once again, they can go top, but it looks like they're going to try and pop Moon. They're going to get the full combo here, but they have to send him back. That was a smart play, but it's still not enough. Moon, he's too farmed. He's too tanky at this point in that time. Now he's going to turn it around. Limbo is going to be held up by that Cold Feet, and simple right clicks are going to secure the job. Now Moon's going to go on Capron, and he's not letting him escape this time. Throws down the 4-second stun. FNG going for the kill, but he doesn't have the right click damage to go for it. Legion coming in from behind, going on J4, trying to finish up that squishy support, and then maybe get the chance to go on more. Iceberg lands the RP, but only on Moon, and they don't have damage. EMP going out. How could they possibly pursue without the mana? Now, Magnus being held up by the stun. Legion's going to go down. Scandal, can he go for more here? He's got no abilities, actually. So in the end, Power Rangers will back up. Doosa losing a lot of heroes despite their large number of rotations, and I can't believe this, but yes. FNG does go down. Yeah, those Visage Familiars, man, too strong.
Yeah, also the courier just died somewhere here. I don't know. There was nothing in
really?
It, so that's all right. Yeah, and in the meantime, this freaking Timbersaw is getting a bit out of hand. He's got 2.2k gold, so there is going to be a very early Bloodstone going his way, and this is going to be very scary. If the Timbersaw can have his game, pick up the Bloodstone at a very good timing. He's just going to have so much mana in all the team fights. He can just spam out whatever the hell he wants. Just press all the buttons, kill all the heroes.
Yep, that's it sounds pretty simple, and I think it's going to be as easy as what you say. Cheshire Cat with this amount of farm. Timbersaw, like, is a hero who needs to be able to sit in lane and farm up a little bit. Sometimes you leave after mana boots. Sometimes occasionally you have the opportunity to just sit in your lane all the way until you have that Bloodstone. And so looking like Cheshire Cat's going to be able to do that, just that. And if he does pick up the Bloodstone, good time will hold up. Gank on three. Cheshire Cat brought back into the tier two tower and done for as Doosa make that rotation. So they do shut down the Timbersaw a little bit, but I think Cheshire Cat, well worth it considering the amount of farm and how aggressively he was pushing in that bottom lane. I mean, he secured a tier one tower with the Timbersaw. That's impressive by yourself, because Timbersaw is not known for his right clicks.
Yeah, and our top lane, they're going to be going onto Limbo once again. Moon is here running away, but they do have a lift. Yes, well played. Now, is there going to be a relocate out? No, the Wisp is not level 6, and they're going to turn. This means death. Yes, Captain Love, 3 seconds done, gets it blown up, and well, that's how fast it goes.
Yeah, you think you're on the offensive, but all of a sudden the Wisp is there, and you got to start regretting that toss. Now, Limbo in some trouble, 2 seconds stun, but it's going to be enough to secure the kill. Legion bounces back with a small spike carapace, but they're going to go one. They keep on pursuing, man. Moon and FNG do not stop, and with the Timbersaw joining them, why should they stop? They pick up yet another kill. 11-5 now on the board. One kill, a minute, relocate back to base, and they're just going to heal up and continue this pressure on the Tier 1 tower. Not only are they picking up creeps, they're killing creeps, they're killing heroes, but they're also killing towers.
Yeah. The only big thing for Dusa going the way was just Scandal, and he got caught out by the Visage as well as the Magnus. They expended pretty much everything in the book there, but no RP, so that's wonderful. And they just got the kill, which means Capron is looking at a rather early-ish mechanism. He's a support, he's playing the 4 position, so he won't have too much, but still, he just needs 500 more gold, and then he's looking at a shiny new mechanism, which is going to mean so much for the whole team, because they are lacking everything right now, and they need the mech. They need it bad.
Yeah, they need the mech, they need the blink dagger for Magnus, which is going to be up pretty soon. So once they have that, maybe they actually have enough power to turn this around on Power Rangers, despite the fact that they've given up a rather large gold lead, almost over 7,500 gold lead for Power Rangers, and over 5,000 experience. They're going to go on Limbo here, stunning them up. Ice Blast will land. Moon still trying to get off that Reality Rift, does get it in the end, but they have to retreat. Is now being pursued out. Stun's going to miss, but Timbersaw comes in from behind, cleans up the Rubick. Now going to go for the Visage. Getting in front of him, does have a Chakram up in just a second, but Limbo is actually going to turn around and finish him off. And Moon gets low, pops the ultimate, try and dodge that hit, still gets it, but just a simple toss. Limbo doesn't have enough mana. He can't actually get the toss for the Nyx Assassin, which would have meant yet another kill, and FNG gonna bring Moon back to base. They're just not needing this relocate to actually gank, because just their presence in lane seems to find kills.
Yeah, absolutely, and just regenerating back up, and just go straight back to shutting down the Tiny. Tiny can't lane there. He's got 34 CS. We've got 12 minutes in the game. That's ridiculous. And yeah, smart play by the Wisp. Just always finding the openings. You don't even need to relocate offensively. If you can't find the kills anyways, why? Smart play.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Orchid is going to be up soon for Scandal. So not only has he just had complete free farm in the lane, but he's been a part of a couple of kills. 2 kills to his name. And an early Orchid means that Ghost Walk, like, you've seen a lot in pubs, but not so much in pro games, where you get an early Orchid on your Invoker, you Ghost Walk around, anything you run into is dead. Like, anything that is left alone by itself is dead, just because the Orchid mixed in with all the magic damage you can output, even if it isn't the straight damage of Exort, it's still enough to get the kill.
Yeah, especially considering we do have an Ancient Apparition on the field who's going to be providing you with an Ice Blast, because, well, if you got someone out there, you're going to have a Tornado, you've got EMP, just as you mentioned, like, you can bring down anyone you want, and then there is going to be an Ice Blast and a Wisp Relocate as well. So you're going to be looking at insane amount of damage whoever is going to get caught out alone, and this might be Iceberg mid lane. Now he's running away. They're going to be finding the Rubick, though, and there is top lane. Look at Limbo once again, 4 seconds stun right in his face, and there is going to be double familiar stuns. Can they find it? No, they cannot. FNG is getting turned around. They actually turn around. Moon is now on the run as well. Moon has to run away so bad. Pops his drums. Can he get away? Doesn't actually look like it, because here comes Legion. It's another throw, and they're going to be picking up the Moon here. Big kills going the way of Dusa.
That was huge, and I love the way Limbo built, man. I mean, this is a normal build, but he always has strength treads. That's smart, but he knew he needed every bit of stats, so instead of, like, trying to actually save up for the full drums, he gets the Bracer as soon as possible, and it really did make the difference. Now being held up, good Tornado EMP. It's actually going to burn out all 3 heroes, all of their mana. Now, fortunately, they do have a lot of mana boot heroes, and that's something that I think has really been lacking, as the Quas Wex Invoker used to be back in the day with Dota 1. Whenever you saw Quas Wex Invoker, which was kind of favored at the time with Tornado EMP being so strong, everybody got mana boots. And you had at least 2 mana boots for every single team, and that really hasn't happened as much. I think for many professional teams, and I think it's just, you know, forgetting how important that is up against the EMP. But this team for Dusa, they've got plenty of room for mana boots. It's going to be on both of their cores, and you expect both supports to pick it up eventually as well.
Yeah, and the big deal is not only the mana boots, because you need a lot of mana to actually activate those thingies. You need like, what, 35? Yeah, it just got nerfed a bit. So in order to be very effective, you need a bit of base mana. And there comes the magic stick, very handy, because they are going to be finding a lot of, well, spells. And the magic stick, you just need like 3 charges or 4 charges in order to get up your arcane boots. And with quad arcane boots, which are very much possible, just as you mentioned, like Captain Love can pick up one, Capron as well. And then they are spawning quad arcane boots, which means the EMP damage is still there, which is pure damage. It's ridiculously high, but it's not that big of a deal. And now they're even dewarding, and I feel like Duzar can crawl back in the game on the back of some amazing Magnus initiations, actually.
Oh, yeah, they've got a lot of really good AoE. They've got so many AoE stuns that absolutely, like, they don't have to wait until the full tiny Aghanims to actually take use of all that splash damage. They've got enough AoE stuns to be able to make this RP worth a lot. They're actually going to be able to find Nyx Assassin here, but they don't know. It's a trap. Iceberg, where's the blink? Where's the blink? He's not going in just yet. They already killed the Nyx Assassin. Now going to go in for more. Cheshire Cat, there's the RP. Getting both of them in that combo. Well played by Iceberg, but they got to get out of here. They might have just killed the two most dangerous heroes, but there's still more on the map. Cheshire Cat has a Bloodstone. He's getting a lot of extra regen out of this. Limbo will fall due to the Orchid. He can do nothing about it. And now even more. Tornado's going to hit Captain Love, and now he's going to go down as well. Cheshire Cat, he just needs to get close enough. Somebody's going to have something to kill this squishy support. And there it is, finally. Cheshire Cat gets the Timber Chain away. Four heroes go down. Verdusa, in exchange for the Tiny Wisp, or not the Tiny Wisp, the Chaos Knight Wisp. Gotta say, that's worth it.
Yeah, also I see a lot of people just hanging out in chat and talking about the game, which is great. But the point people try to make is that Tiny has a higher win rate percentage when he's played alone without the Wisp, as opposed to Wisp with the Wisp. And this is actually very much misleading, because he's functioning very, 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 very well with the Wisp. And this is what Fnatic just orchestrated perfectly. But if you're not sporting the Wisp, you need some other hero who can actually work very well with it. And this is mostly the Lion. And this is how Fnatic actually plays him without the Wisp. It's with the Lion. And Duzar don't have it. So all these stats, like, without the Wisp, to quote-unquote, is a high win percentage. Yeah, it is true. He's 13 for 2 or something. But still, it doesn't really count, because they don't have the Lion. And that's very much misleading. And so far, well, I just can't say, like, Power Rangers, their draft was so spot on. And the only thing here Duzar can do, actually, to come back in this game is going to be the Tiny getting empowered up, which is exactly what happens now, and find a perfect RP. But you're banking on Power Rangers grouping up a bit too much. And I feel like this is a bad idea, because Power Rangers, as you mentioned early on, they are the Monster Slayers. They are the Tier 1 Team Slayers, and they are still looking so strong.
Yep, Moon going to go in for more. Going to catch out. Oh, Limbo. Nice Avalanche stun. And they don't want to pursue uphill, but they will take control of this Tier 2 tower. It looks like clean that up. Capron in a bad position here, stunned up, and make it bursted down. Cheshire Cat not throwing the Chakra Mount. Now going to get it. Hits two heroes, and that's going to be enough to clean both of them up. Double kill goes his way. Ice Blast forcing Duzar back. Now Limbo gets a 3-second stun in a bad position, but there goes the RP. Three man, but where's the damage? They don't. Everybody's dead. It doesn't matter if you hit a big RP if there's no damage to follow it up, and they just get chased into their base. Limbo with the buyback. But he's going to go down once again. GG being called from Captain Love as Duzar buy back in an attempt to actually make that RP worth something. But all it results in is more kills going the way of Power Rangers. 23-11, 19 minutes in. And Power Rangers looking much stronger than they did in their series up against Fnatic.
What a game. I would have thought this block pick would work out better, I guess. But the thing is, if you don't take it late, if the Magnus can't find the farm he really needs, and especially the Tiny, if Tiny doesn't have a tree with him, as well as another item right after, I feel like this is just a bit too optimistic to try to bring everyone down with a 4 to, I don't know, like a 3 to 5 mana piece. So, well, it was a good idea by Duzar. They don't want to give away the Tiny, but, well, Power Rangers, they had the number there. There was, I feel like this was a bit of baiting. I mean, get the CK and don't get the Tiny. That's fine-ish. Cap, do you live? Hello? I guess Cap's away. Am I muted? I guess I'm muted. Okay, bye guys. See you in the second.